I'm a dreamer, a professional dreamer. And if you're one like me with a worldwide vision, then having a dream is not enough. You have to break it down into chunks, into daily executionable goals. And that is also not enough. You need to have the grit, you need to have the determination, you need to have the commitment. And above all, if you really, really want to be at the receiving end of the manifestation of your dreams, then you also have to make language and communication your greatest strength, especially English. That is the context of my video today, where I will also be telling you about an English speaking app which will get you right there. This is Priya Kumar. I'm a motivational speaker and author, and I'm here in Pahalgam for the shoot of Final Call, which is a web series based on my book I Will Go With You, which will soon be on Z5. I am a dreamer, and when I started my career as a motivational speaker and writer, I was very clear. I am going out there in the world. I'm going to be rooted here in India, but spread my wings worldwide. And therefore, English became compulsory. See, it's great to be proficient in your mother tongue. I am. But it is also very, very important to be fluent in a language that most of the world understands, and that happens to be English. You know, I know of this gentleman. He's an acquaintance. He's a politician. And he was going abroad. He was called to address a forum on a very, very important worldwide platform. So he went there. He had worldwide exposure. And the gentleman gave his entire speech in Hindi, and there were subtitles when his speech was relayed. Now here's the thing, I love this idea of love my country. I love my country. I am patriotic, and so is this gentleman. But he had the opportunity to reach out to the world. See, if you're speaking in India, please speak in Hindi if that is your audience. A leader must understand his audience and speak in that language. But he had an opportunity to address the world and direct their attention to India, and he spoke in Hindi. Now, you will agree with me, as much as there were subtitles, you know, the subtitles don't make the same impact. He knew English, by the way, but he said, oh, my English is not that good. Hey, if your vision is that big, you should start now. Before you became a politician, you wanted that world stage. So from that day, your effort should have started to taking the stage on and making the impact that you have dreamt to make. You know, I love reading biographies. So I'm currently reading the biography of Jack Ma, who is the founder of Alibaba. It's so inspiring. I write biographies and I read them. Now, did you know Jack Ma lives in China, and he took a Chinese company to the world? And he said, I realized very early that if I wanted to go out into the world and bring the world's attention to China in an inspirational context, I had to learn the language. So he started to learn English. And he writes in the book that learning English was not enough if I didn't get to practice it every day. See, I learned French, but because I didn't get to practice it on a daily basis, I began to forget it. So what he started to do was he started to teach English. He became an English teacher. He even started a translation agency where he would translate English to Chinese and Chinese to English to keep his proficiency in the language going. Today, Jack Ma is a billionaire. Maybe he's more than a billionaire, but more than that, he is an inspirational figure. If you hear his speeches, my God, you get goosebumps. The guy is brilliant. And I believe that anybody who's chasing his dreams and going after a purpose is inspirational. And if you get to communicate that, my God, you have the attention of the world. Jack Ma is one. There are so many examples. There is Vijay Sharma, who's the founder of Paytm. Now, he says that when he wanted to get into engineering, English was important, and he was not good with English. You know what he used to do? He used to buy two books, one in Hindi, one in English, so he could learn and then reference it back to Hindi to see if he had understood it. That's amazing, because he understood one thing very, very clearly. Because you see, it's very simple. You may have a great idea, you may have a great project, you may be extremely good, but how do you get that out of your notebook and out of your head into the market? You have to communicate, and the distance of your vision will decide which language you're going to communicate in. In that context, English becomes very, very important. Like I already mentioned, I am a patriot. I believe that your mother tongue should be your language of power, but you also have to learn the language of the audience you are addressing. See, if a foreigner comes to work in rural India, English is not going to work, right? Even if he gets a translator, he's going to lose the impact in the communication. He is going to have to learn Hindi if he is going to make a difference. Similarly, if my vision is worldwide, then I have to learn English. The translation is not going to help. And you know what? When you're a non-English speaking person and you've made the effort to get good at it, you've got the heart and the pulse of the people, because in your voice, in your words, in your accent, they can hear your dedication, they can hear your commitment. And that is a very, very big plus point for a dreamer who is going for the goalpost. Now, I have said this in my previous videos, but I love this English speaking app called Cambly. Now, it's a paid app. I cannot tell you how many people commented, oh, the app is so expensive and it's a paid app and there are free apps. Come on, which dream comes for free? Nothing comes for free. Even the air you are breathing is going to cost you money eventually in the hospital bills with the amount of pollution that is. There's nothing free. And look, this app is not a robot. It's not a set curriculum, which your free paid apps are, by the way. There is a tutor on the other end who's going to speak at your level. So if you're a student and you have set the context of that conversation that, look, I'm an engineering student or I'm a student applying for my entrance exam for the US or the UK, now the tutor speaks to you at that level. It's customized. If you're somebody who's moving abroad, they speak to you in that context. If you're a housewife who wants to perfect the English, they speak to you at that level. It's not a robotic one shoe fits all method. There is amazing conversation that you have with the tutor, which is relevant to you. And the best part is you decide the context, you decide the flow, you decide the conversation, and you decide the time. And you have a choice what kind of English you want. You want Australian English, you want UK English, you want American English, depending on what your vision is. And personally, I have totally enjoyed the app. You know, sometimes you get little nuances if you want a particular accent. And I was really, really wishing that I had this app in another language. I'm gonna request Cambly to make this app in other languages so I can learn French and I can learn Russian and I can learn Korean and I can learn Chinese, because my vision is not just going on a worldwide platform but also going deeper into those little pockets where people are still not speaking English. But anyways, let's stick to the English speaking app. It's very, very simple. You download it, it's Cambly, you sign in, you select your context, you select your purpose, you select your region, and once in, the adventure begins. You can select a tutor, you sign in, and you know all the green buttons that you see, those are the tutors that are available. So you can just click on to one and, you know, just have a chat with the person. And I will tell you this, all of them are so nice. They are well qualified. Like if you ask them, who are you? And you know, sometimes even allowing the tutor to speak gives you so much clarity about the accent. So every conversation that I have had is so amazing. Well, you would ask me, Priya, why do you need the app? Well, let me tell you, there's always room for improvement. And sometimes, end of the day, you just want to have conversation with a like-minded person. And I do that. And it's fun. I mean, these people are brilliant. They are educated. They have other jobs and they are tutors in English. Actually, let me show you one of the calls that I did with the tutors so you will understand not only is it a learning process, it's also super fun at your convenience. And you know, somebody like me, professionals like me, where we're working during the day, we don't have time to go for a class in the evening or, you know, take time out of our busy lives. There's already no time. So this app is at your convenience and at any time, 24/7. So even if it is 12 a.m. in India, it could be daytime somewhere else, there's a tutor available 24/7 at your convenience. This app cannot be free. Hey, would you be a tutor for free? No. So that justifies the payment for the download. So anyways, okay, let's see. I had so much fun talking to this tutor.
Hello.
Hello. Hi.
Hello. Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Very well, thank you. My name is Priya Kumar. I'm an author.
Yes. Yeah. You're an author. Do you write books?
Yes, thank you. That's very sweet of you.
Ah.
So I wanted to know how does chatting with a tutor, how does that benefit the person who logs in?
Do depends on what level. I get a lot of PhDs, people doing doctorates, who come to me, they want this explained in English, or they want to improve their English. I have a lot of medical people coming to me, a psychiatrist, because their patients are English. A psychiatrist, a psychologist, a dentist, and a urologist I've had. Mm-hmm. Please help me improve my English. I need to speak a better English to my patients. Oh. So we get medical people, it depends very much. We get businessmen who really need to be able to negotiate on a high level. Others who have to present their companies on a very high international level. And then they will go over their presentations with me. Other students from universities like studying manpower, they will come to me with, I've studied manpower too, so they will come to me with problems about their studies and ask me for help, and suddenly I'm not teaching English, I'm teaching manpower. So okay. It depends on what level, you know.
It was lovely speaking with you. Thank you very much for your time.
Okay.
All right. Bye-bye. So as a parting note, let me say that our exposure is growing. This is the era of the dreamer. And if your dreams are worldwide, then get into the language the world speaks. Like I said earlier, have mastery over your mother tongue, but also have fluency in English, because that is where the big manifestation of your dreams lie. And if your purpose is a worthy one, encompassing the world, then it is your responsibility to communicate it and bring others in that benefit. So I hope this helps. This is Priya Kumar signing up from Pahalgam. Hey, you have to read my book, I Will Go With You, and you have to watch the web series Final Call. Arjun Rampal is the main lead, and Anshuman Malhotra is another character. I'm not going to tell you which one, but you will hear about it, or maybe you've already heard about it. It's being shot in such exotic locations that I am such a big beneficiary of this entire project. Now that's a dream coming true. And how? I had seen that dream, but you know what? Z5 has taken that to beyond my imagination. And I'm always ever so grateful to you and the people who are connected with me for keeping me busy with the worthy purpose of serving you. I'm doing my best, and I know you are too. So I will see you again next week. Until then, bye-bye.